Step into the spotlight. Hello, it's your boy Davidoff, and today we have got Jarman MP 2016 highlights and the story of the Little Master. Now, this is a Saturday video. Don't worry, I am doing round 15. Okay, I'm doing the Friday game and the first two Saturday games in one video, then the rest of the Saturday game in the other video, then all the Sunday games. So, doing three videos of three games, basically. But for now, we've got these two videos. Let's start with Jarman MP. Interesting start there. So he's a poor athlete player. Some good bits of play here, isn't there? There he is. Look at that for a kick. It's a good mark, yeah, but what a pass that was to get it to him in the first place. That was brilliant. Nice one. There we go. It's a nice run here. That was almost an amazing goal. Almost an amazing goal. How unlucky is that though? Hit the post after all that. Decent players, guys. There we go. Love it. Go on, go on, go on, go on, boom! That's awesome. That's how you stop him, that's how you stop an attack, a potential attack. There you go. That was a nice little pass there. He's releasing off me and also allowing Young some space so they can identify the players they're out of here. Skilled pass there. A nice kick as well. There you go.
Chris, watch him with a push back, fly for the mark. Nothing really happened in there, but hard work by Blair.
There you go, sidestepped him there. Good pass as well. Nice goal. Once again. Close. Boom. Madness. Brilliant once again. What's going on? Physical in their approach to the tackle. Robbie Pryor lifts the hand on the jar and Impey on the run. A little push off on Gibson. And bounced away with some arrogance. Left it out. Sliced him up. Still going. That was a great run. He was stopped in the end, but that was a great run. Nice mark. Go on. What a great play there. That was a brilliant assist. He's good at those little runs. He's good at beating people in his runs. Look at that. Once that, just like I said, he's good at those little things. So hard to get as well. He's done some brilliant tackles in this game too. Left him on the floor. There we go. Boom. Decent mark. Decent goal. That was a bullet. Power, accuracy, in. He's good at these little runs, as I've said multiple times. Almost up a great mark, but the guy didn't mark it. It's a good mark by him just now. Look at that for a run. What a brilliant assist. That was an awesome assist. That was the end of the video as well. But yeah, some brilliant pieces of play. He's really good at those runs, isn't he? Very talented player. I love that. He's so exciting to watch as well. So yeah, that was absolutely awesome. Some great assists in there, some great runs, a few good marks too, some very good tackles as well. So yeah, an all round good video.
I'm just a pretty cruisy, easygoing guy. You know, someone that
Junior.
Loves my sport, loves my family. Been in the footy industry 16 years now, it's been a huge part of my life.
The stars are at the ground level, and there's none brighter than Gary Edwards.
It's been a lot. You know, I can still remember growing up as a kid. Spending most of my time around the Geelong Football Club. I used to love going down and watching my dad train, play on the weekends. And it was always
great sure.
to play at the top level.
That's so cool.
There was a small period in my life where I lost interest in football. You know, I had a few other passions at the time, but got to the age of about 16 and realised that and realised how much I loved the game and how much I really did want to play at the top level. You know, got drafted down there, spent 9 years at the Geelong Cats, and then, you know, been up here on the coast for 7 years now.
Are you pretty happy with the way you went?
Well, not really. I think I could have done better, but...
How would you play better?
I'll get a few more kicks and...
What's your favourite position?
Ruck or overall.
Same as a kid.
Now, of course, everybody knows about your old man. What's it like having the Gary Ablett name to carry around?
Oh, it's like any other kid. Just...
I first saw Gary Ablett Jr. in the change rooms at Cadenia Park, the Geelong change rooms. Dad was playing, so he's having a fair dinkum team meeting. This private room, the door just swings open, and in walks little Gary about this high and says, "Dad, are we going home yet?" It broke up the meeting, I think it was a pretty tough meeting at the time, and I started laughing, so the whole group started laughing. So that was my introduction to Gary, being a nice lad, but a cheeky little boy. Him and Nathan, his brother, around the club room, they would they'd kick the footy mad. Energy. I've never seen two kids with so much energy.
So what about Dad?
He's
what?
He's done well.
And what about you, Nathan? What do you think about that?
Oh, he has good snaps and he's really good.
He's a good player. You both must love your dad very much, do you?
Yes.
Hello.
Nice. Story of the Little Master. Highly presented by Virgin Australia. Okay. There we go. Some footage. Boom.
I probably, in my junior football, never expected to get drafted. I never believed I was good enough to be running around knowing that you know, I was on a senior list and that I had an opportunity that season of playing a game at the top level. You know, it was a pretty amazing feeling.
It's his seventh touch to it. Oh, I get this a
turn. I wanted to make my own name in football, and I spoke to my dad about that. And, you know, he was super supportive. He said as much as he would love me to have his number, but, you know, he completely understands that, you know, me taking the number 29, I guess.
I've been fortunate enough to play with some pretty handy players over the years, but I rate Gary right up there as probably the best player I ever played with all seasons.
It was a really special moment, not for just Nathan and I, but also for my dad. It had been four losing premierships. He was at the game. He was, you know, able to come down to the rooms and celebrate, you know, the premiership with us afterwards. And, you know, the Geelong Football Club had been such a huge part of his life as well. I think I said after the game that I was happy to cut the medal in half, because, you know, no doubt that he deserved the premiership. With all the hard work that he put in over his career.
I think I remember this as well. That was an absolute bullet of a kick. I'm pretty sure I've seen that one as well. That was a brilliant piece of play.
I think back over the 16 years, and there's been a lot of hard work put in.
And he won. The big one. Nice one. I like the way this puts together.
Gary Ablett, the former Geelong superstar turned Gold Coast Suns marquee player. He has just been announced as their captain. He's been given the honour of leading the club in their inaugural season.
Probably the toughest decision of my life, to be honest. the Geelong Football Club have been the team I've supported my whole life. I've been there for 9 years. They were so good to me. Achieved so much there. Super close with all my teammates, still are today. So it was a really tough decision to leave the Geelong Football Club, but probably took me a good 18 months to settle in. I moved away, I didn't know anyone up here. As I mentioned, family was still back in Victoria, but, looking back now, I wouldn't change any decision that I've made, because I really do feel, through all the challenges that we've had as a football club, I've grown a lot as a person, as a leader. And I feel like I've been able to take my football to another level as well.
Held his ground in front, put it into the path of Gary Ablett, and the Masters back.
It actually is a huge honour. You don't really realise it until you see some of the things he does in games.
Did you mention what year it was? What year did he switch?
Just a teammate, but I know, at the end of his career and end of my career, it's going to be great to know that if you played with possibly the greatest player of all time, and that's not something that comes by to every football player, so I'm extremely lucky.
That's a goal! Ablett's kick four!
That was an awesome move, though.
This is getting my way! I'm the master here!
I think what stands out with Gary week to week, he's just so consistent. He's played at an unbelievable level ever since I've played with him up here, and obviously for Geelong as well, so see guys have a good game or two, but Gary had an unbelievable game, just consistently every week. Probably my favourite highlight of the guys was the goal kick against Geelong down there. I think it was his first time he played against Geelong back down there, so I was right next to him when he kicked it, and it was an unreal goal. And
what's it called?
Geelong faithful, really. I think they started applauding him as well, so they knew how good a goal it was.
Yeah, certainly interesting having played with Gary's dad, and now the Eagle with his 300th game coaching him. So I think when I first started, you just assume that all great players just know how to play the game and they've got no insecurities, and it's all fine. And now I've been fortunate to coach some great names, like Paul Kelly and Brad Johnson and Chris Grant, and now Gary. His level of consistency gap that I reckon ranks with Lee Matthews.
Yeah, he certainly played a big hand in the marketing and getting a lot of young people interested in NFL. They come down and watch their first game and see Gary golf in the boundary line or a centre clearance for a goal. It can turn any young kid into an AFL fan. So he's done a lot for the AFL and a lot for the Gold Coast and a lot for our club.
From coming to not believing I was good enough to play at the top level, to thinking if I was able to play one game at the top level, then I'd be satisfied. And I could say that for the rest of my life I would have that, but I could tell you I was able to play at the top level. To going forward 16 years and one game away from 300 games, to say that I've played in three premierships, 1-2, I am very blessed. The opportunities that it's opened up for my family and I.
I declare the winner of the 2013 Brownlow Medal, Gary Ablett, Gold Coast Suns.
Awesome.
To perform as, half as well as your dad, but he's actually getting challenged against his dad as who's the better player. That's a huge pat on the back in itself, but to play with him and to watch him now and get the best out of himself. He was always about bringing other people into the game, and that's what I can always remember of Gaz, and that's what I learnt off him and wanted to, now do to my teammates. And he was a super teammate. He's a super guy.
I want to be remembered as someone that gave my all. I know personally the work that I put in. Someone that made the most of the opportunities that I was given, that the ability that and talent that I was blessed with, but probably more than that, just a man of integrity. That's probably the most important thing to me.
It was nice. That was like a movie in a way. You know, that was like a movie. Good video. Five times AFLPA MVP, eight times All Australian. What's All Australian? You can let me know. Five times club champion, two times ballot medalist, two AFL premierships, 300 games. There you go. I like the way that was put together. It was like a movie in a way. And yeah, it was very different to what I usually react to. And yeah, it was a good video. So thanks for recommendation. That's all my requests done now. If you got any new ones, I'm on holiday next week. In the coming days. So if you've got any requests, then save them. If you're worried you might forget them, then just request them anyway, and I'll react to them when I get back. It might take a while though. But yeah, this is your boy Dabrop. Please like, share, subscribe. Thanks for watching.